Guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. So today I wanted to come to you guys with a bit of a Valentine's Day look inspiration. I went very heavy on the blush and highlighter on purpose because I wanted to look like super pinky and just like in the spirit of Valentine's Day. I don't really celebrate Valentine's Day, not by choice. It's just I've never had a Valentine's, but it's okay. Let me know what you guys are doing for like Valentine's Day and stuff. I don't know, because I don't really have plans, but I would love to know what everyone's getting up to. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys. So I'm just gonna get right into it. So I'm gonna start with these glow illuminating highlight drops from L'Oreal, and I'll just spread them everywhere. Spread that everywhere. Then I'm gonna mix two foundations. So I'm using NW43 and NC50. So I'm gonna use NC50 on the outside of my face and then NW43 on the inside of my face. We're gonna start with the NC50 on the outer part of my face. And I'm trying to be very full coverage, so I'm putting quite a lot. But you don't need to put this much. It just depends on like how much foundation you wanna have on your face. Then I'm gonna go in with the NW43, which is the lighter shade, just in the middle of my face. This is quite a dense brush. It kind of has the same effect of a beauty blender, so afterwards it's a Sephora brush. I don't know the name, but it looks like that. So afterwards I kind of just like tap everything in. I'm gonna use my Too Faced Born This Way concealer in the shade Mocha. Then I'm just gonna blend that out. To contour, I'm gonna use the MAC Studio Tech foundation in NW58, and I'm just gonna go in with my beauty blender because I don't know, I find that like helps blend everything in well together. And I know it looks like I'm like pounding on my face, but this is actually really relaxing and it doesn't hurt anything. So whatever's left here, I'll put it like here by my nose. I'm gonna go in with like bronzer to contour my nose, so that's why I don't need to do too much there. To set that, I'm gonna go in with my MAC Studio Fix powder. I like a very bright under eye. Then I'm gonna use, as per usual, my Morphe palette. It's got a nice brown skin tone shade in there that I used to set the rest of my face. Then I'm gonna set all that using my Laura Mercier translucent powder. Then I'm gonna use my Fenty Beauty bronzer in the shade Mocha Mummy. So I'm gonna go in with my NYX like brow gel in the shade Black. I'm gonna coat my hairs in that. I'm going to go in with this NYX brow pencil and just like fill in the front and just a little bit on the ends too. And I'm just gonna brush them out. So I actually stopped to eat because I got really hungry, but we were doing the brows. So I'm gonna take the darker foundation that I used and I'm gonna carve out the top of my brows. And then for the eyes, I'm gonna put a little bit of just the same concealer that I used on the outer part. And then I'm gonna use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Eye Primer. I'm not gonna put everywhere considering I'm gonna like put more concealer later anyway, but I'm just putting it mainly where I'm gonna have like my first bit of eyeshadow. So we're mainly gonna play with two palettes today. So I'm gonna use my Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette and my Huda Beauty new nude palette. But I'm gonna start with the Modern Renaissance palette. And I am gonna use like these two shades from there. So I'm gonna start with the lighter one. I'm gonna use this Morphe M330. Brush. I'm not gonna name all the brushes. I just figured this has a name, so I would tell you. But and then, so I'm gonna start by blowing out my eye and just bringing that this way. And I'm gonna put it like right by the corner, just so it can like connect with when I do the lower lash line as well. I'm gonna zoom you guys in using a brush that is smaller and a little more dense. I'm gonna go in with the darker shade and basically just follow what I did there. Just to deepen it further, I'm gonna go into my Jackie Aina palette using another like dense brush, and I'm gonna use the shade Credit, which is like a nice brown shade, and I'm pretty much gonna follow the same shape. And to be honest, if you don't like stuff that's like super heavy and like dark, you can stop at the pink shades and just put on some lashes and it'll be fine. But I don't want to do that, so that's why I'm doing this. And you're literally just like deepening that shape and lifting, just to like lift the eye. I don't know if you guys can see the difference between like this side and this side. Like really, this side is more lifted. I'm just taking that brown shade like halfway. I have found that cutting your crease with a very tiny, precise brush like this makes a big difference. So that's what I've been doing quite a lot. We're just gonna go in with the same shades that we've been using. So, starting with that dark shade, Credit, from the Jackie Aina palette, we're gonna just blend it into the concealer. Back into the Modern Renaissance palette, using that darker shade, we're gonna blend that, what is this? I think it's like a brown. So we're gonna blend that dark brown into this. So we're gonna go into the new nude palette and take this shade, it's called Daydream. I'm just gonna blend these like the purple and the shimmer into each other again. Then we're just gonna do the shades that we used at the top, we're gonna use at the bottom. This is why I had like brought this shade like quite low, just so I could connect like the bottom part of my eye to the top part. But anyway, with a smaller brush, we're gonna go into the Jackie Aina palette and use that brown shade Credit. I'm gonna do the other eye and then I'll be back to show you guys both eyes. I'm just gonna put a little bit of this MAC Eye Kohl on my eye. I do want to add just like a pop of color in the inner corner. So I'm going to take back to the Jackie Aina palette. I'm going to take the shade Trust Issues. And I'm just going to pop that in the inner corner here. Then I'm going to take this House of Tara blush in the shade Amaria. By the way, any House of Tara products that you guys see me using, you can get them at Feli Cheetah Artistry here in Winnipeg. And you can use my code P10 to save money on all orders over 45. So if you guys want to use this blush, you can use my code and get the blush. It's very pigmented, so you just gotta go in lightly. I mean, you don't have to put this much, but I love blush and I like those looks where it just like extends high up onto the face. Then I'm gonna take the Smashbox blush palette. It has this like really pretty pinky highlighter shade that I'm gonna put on top of that to like blend it together. And maybe I'll put a little bit of like that as well. Now that we're shining, we're gonna do the lips. I'm gonna go in with this NYX brown pencil thing. It's just like a regular brown. I guess we're not gonna use that. Then I'm gonna go in with my MAC Cosmetics Lady Be Good liquid lip. Once that dries, I'm just gonna remove this headband. Yeah. Oh, and I'm gonna do lip gloss as well. This is the finished look. I really hope you guys like it. Thank you so much for watching. I decided to wear this like frilly pinky top in the spirit of Valentine's Day. Let me know what you guys are doing for Valentine's Day, if anyone has any plans or if anyone's gonna be spending it at home, most probably like I will be doing. But yeah, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe and turn on your post notifications so you're notified anytime I make a new post. But yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.